All right, first of all, the procedure lasts from 2 to maximum 4 hours. The day of the procedure, I expect you to have a good dinner, and then the day of the procedure, nothing to eat because I would expect you to be nil by mouth, empty stomach. That is because I want to make sure that there is no interaction with the anesthetics and the drugs that we're going to give you so that the whole journey is more pleasant. Right after the procedure, you might experience some fluid leaking from the incisions that I will do. The incisions that I do are usually very small, are just 4 millimeters in size, and I put them in very anatomically hidden places so that if you're very worried about them, you're not going to be able to notice them. Areas such as the groin, the armpits, the belly button, all those areas in which you're not really able to see them. From those areas, as I said, you're going to experience some fluid leakage that will last 3 days. In order to facilitate that fluid leakage, sometimes I put just 2 centimeters long drains, and that will help you with getting the area as dry as possible. What is that fluid? That fluid is partly your own fluid that you create as a reaction to the inflammatory process, but also, and that's most of it, is the fluid that I insert in the first phase of the vasoliposuction when I want to numb the area using the fluid that I mentioned earlier. The procedure is done under local anesthesia. That's usually done for the majority of my patients. However, there are some of the patients that I treat that prefer general anesthetic, and that's when I deal with patients that don't want to feel absolutely anything and they don't want to have any issues right after the procedure itself. For that, we have our anesthesiologist and our anesthetist nurse that will take care of you during and after the procedure for a more pleasant experience.